In order to get fusion reactions going, you need to keep your fuel hot enough and dense enough, like the center of a star. And you need to keep it like that for long enough for fusion reactions to occur. This is encapsulated in something called the fusion triple product, NT tau E. Density, temperature, and the amount of time the energy is trapped are all multiplied together. And this needs to be bigger than a certain number to achieve fusion ignition. Tokamaks have shown good progress over time. But there is wiggle room. We could have higher density and lower temperature and a long, long time, like in the sun where hydrogen fuses to make helium. Or on Earth, if we fuse heavy hydrogen, we need higher temperatures so can have lower density and a shorter time and still get to fusion conditions. This means that there are various different approaches when it comes to fusion and various different designs of fusion machine.
How many ways are there to achieve fusion that can give you net energy gain and have it be a possible way to produce electricity? And you know, maybe half a dozen ways so far have achieved really truly fusion relevant conditions.
There are two main ways of confining or trapping hot fusion fuels. These are magnetic confinement and inertial confinement. Magnetic confinement uses magnetic fields to trap the hot fusion fuel, usually in a machine called a tokamak, or sometimes a stellarator. Inertial confinement uses a fuel pellet's own inertia, that is, its inability to move away fast enough, to keep the fuel trapped and hot. Intense laser beams compress a tiny fuel pellet to obtain fusion conditions in the center of the pellet. Others use shock waves. The most heavily researched approaches are tokamaks on the magnetic side and laser fusion on the inertial side.
A fusion plasma is a fusion plasma. They might have slightly different collisionalities and need slightly different theoretical models. But in the end, the foundational science is very much overlapping. Certainly, I worked myself most directly in magneto-inertial fusion, and we very much use the same theoretical constructs and modeling tools from both sides. So I do think there's a strong overlap in the science.
Historically, government funding was channeled into these two main approaches, which has resulted in some very large, impressive facilities, like JET, ITER, and NIF. The JET tokamak currently holds the world record for fusion power produced. Also, a lot of research has gone into understanding the fundamentals of fusion and plasma physics, as well as the specifics of these approaches. But there are other possible ways of achieving fusion. Other methods being investigated are magnetized target fusion, the field reverse configuration, the sustained spheromak, the dense plasma focus, the sheared flow stabilized Z-pinch, and more.
Having a lot of approaches is a good thing for fusion. It diversifies the risk because a lot of the concepts have different risk profiles. They have different technological, you know, reactor engineering requirements, and also pursuing multiple approaches actually, it cross-fertilizes ideas at this point, which I think is useful.